Today we will take up question number 7 of module number 4 of reviewing of question paper December 19, January 20. The first question what is asked, with a neat sketch explain the construction of the various parts of a DC generator for 8 mass. Here you have to draw the neat sketch as well as you have to explain the each part of the DC machine. We know that in the case of the rotating machine you have got a two parts. One is the armature, that is the rotating part here in the case of a DC generator, and the field is at a stationary part, that is in the stator. The purpose of the armature is to provide energy conversion in the case of a DC generator. Here the actual, there is a generated voltage. The purpose of the field winding is to create the magnetic flux. Usually in the case of a DC generator, they are using for electromagnets, that you have to write. Then there are two types of field windings they are using. Either it is a series or a shunt, or the combination of both series and shunt, then it is called as a compound generator. Usually the shunt field, that is shunt field, is connected across the armature, whereas the series field is connected in series with the armature. Therefore, the series field resistance should be very small and the shunt field resistance should be high, so that because it is connected across the armature. Then the armature, we know that it is a rotating part. In the case of the DC generator, it consists of armature conductors, and it is placed in the slots of the outer periphery of the rotor. Then both the armature as well as the stator is made up of laminations, so that they can reduce the iron losses in the machine. Then in each slots you are putting the conductors, are put in the slots of the armature core. The conductors are connected in a particular fashion. In the case of the DC generator, it is either connected in wave winding or a lap winding. Then we know that in the case of a generated voltage in the armature of the DC generator is alternating in the nature. To get the DC output from the DC generator, then we need a commutator as well as the brush gear arrangement from AC to get a DC. That is, alternating voltage is produced in the coil rotating in the machine field. To obtain DC current in the external circuit, a commutator is needed. The commutator which rotates along with the armature. The current produced in the armature winding is passed on to the commutator, then external circuit by means of the brushes. You have to draw this neat circuit diagram. You have to label the parts of the DC generator. Okay, for neat circuit diagram, it is carrying the 60% of the mass, and the 40% of the mass is meant for the explanation. Then he is asked in the question number 7b, explain the significance of a back EMF in a DC motor. Here I am explaining with the help of a modeling, electrical modeling of a DC motor. That is, the motor can be represented by an armature and the applied voltage V. Then because of the generating action in the motor, we have got a back EMF EB. The direction of this back EMF is given by Lenz's law, means it is exactly opposite to the applied voltage. If we are correlating the relation between the voltage applied and the back EMF, we know that you can apply the KVL for this circuit. The applied voltage V must be equal to back EMF plus IRA drop. Therefore, I am writing here V is equal to EB plus IRA. Therefore, if from this equation I am calculating EB, EB is equal to V minus IRA volts. Then what I am interested here is, what is the current drawn by the armature, this I. Therefore, I can be calculated from this equation. Once again, I am transferring this EB to this side, IRA to the other side, so that I am getting I is equal to V minus EB divided by RA. At the same time, we know that what is the value of EB. EB is equal to 5ZNP by 60 into A. Here I am writing an equation, then I have to look into the condition, the significance of back EMF at two different conditions. That is, at the time of starting, when it is taking a full load. Okay, the two conditions we will see. Then what is the significance of the back EMF, we will see. At the time of starting, the rotor is at rest, means the speed is zero. Therefore, what we are getting? The back EMF is zero. Therefore, because L is 0 at the time of starting, therefore back EMF is 0. Therefore, current drawn by the armature is I is equal to V by RA. We know that the applied voltage is very high, that is around 440 volts if we are taking an example. And the armature resistance is, it is 0.01 or 0.02, that is 440 divided by 0.01. That is, you imagine the what is the magnitude of the armature current drawn at the time of starting. It is very high current it is drawing at the time of starting because the back EMF is 0. Therefore, to start the DC motor, we need a starter, because at the time of starting, the machine will draw heavy current because the back EMF is 0. Then you take another condition, when it is running with its rated speed, that is when it is running with rated speed, that is we have got a N is a rated speed, therefore back EMF is produced in the DC motor. Then under normal the speed, the back EMF is almost equal to the applied voltage. It is nearer to the applied voltage. Therefore, the difference between the applied voltage and back EMF is very, very small. That is V minus EB is very, very small, because under the rated speed, the back EMF is nearer to the voltage V. Therefore, the difference is very small. Thereby, the current drawn by the armature is less. This is how we have to explain the significance of the back EMF in the DC motor. Question number 7C is also on a DC shunt generator. It is given that the DC shunt generator delivers a current of 496 amperes at 440 volts. The resistance of the shunt field is 110 ohm and the armature winding resistance is 0.02. Calculate the EMF induced in the armature. He asks you to find out what is the EMF generated in the generator. First, you have to draw the circuit. I have drawn here the circuit of the DC shunt generator. I am marking all the current in the circuit diagram. At the same time, the given data I displayed here. That is, IL is 496. The applied, that is, terminal voltage is 440 volts. Then, shunt field resistance is 110 ohm. And the armature resistance is 0.02. Then, how we are finding out the E? E must be is equal to the applied voltage V plus IRA drop plus brush drop plus the reduction in the voltage because of the armature reaction. First, we will write down the what are the data given. It is a shunt generator. IL is given, and that is the terminal voltage is given, the shunt field resistance as well as the armature resistance. Then the equation for E is, that is V plus IRA plus brush drop plus the reduction in the voltage because of the armature reaction, that is V plus IRA. Then if you look into the E, brush drop is not given, therefore you are treated as 0. Armature reaction is also not mentioned in the problem, therefore you take it as a 0. Therefore, ultimately you have to leave with E is equal to V plus IRA. Then if you look into the data given, the V is given, that is 440 volts. RA is given, that is 0.02 ohm. However, he is not given the value of IA. But other data, how to find out IA? That is, IA must be equal to IL plus ISH. IA is equal to IL plus ISH. To find out IA, I know the value of IL, but however, I don't know the value of ISH. The ISH value can be calculated by, he is given the voltage across the load. The same voltage is appearing across the shunt field resistance. Resistance is given, voltage is given, therefore the current can be calculated. Therefore, shunt field current ISH is equal to V divided by RSH. RSH, that is equal to what you are getting is 440 divided by 110, that is equal to 4 amperes you are getting. Therefore, you have to find out the value of I. I is equal to IL plus ISH. Therefore, I is equal to, it is, IL is 496 already is given. ISH you are calculated as a 4 amperes. Then the total armature current I is 500 amperes. Therefore, we know all the values of the in this equation. Therefore, just you have to substitute these values. E is equal to 440 plus 500 into 0.02. Therefore, the voltage what we are getting is, the generated voltage is 450 volts. This is how you have to calculate the generated voltage.